गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी कंपैरिजन ऑफ एडजेक्टिव. वी आल्सो कॉल इट डिग्री ऑफ कंपैरिजन. डिग्रीज ऑफ कंपैरिजन आर यूज्ड व्हेन वी डिस्क्राइब अ पर्सन और अ थिंग. सो व्हेन वी डिस्क्राइब अ पर्सन और अ थिंग देन वी यूज डिग्रीज ऑफ comparison. Adjective makes the comparison. Always remember that adjective are describing words. As I told here that degree of comparison are used when we describe a person or thing. So adjectives are making the comparison. And what are adjectives? Adjectives are describing words. So degrees of comparison are used when we compare one person or one thing with another. There are three degrees of comparison. What are those? Positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. Now what is positive comparison means? What is positive degree? Positive degree is used for when we only describe one person or thing. So students, when we speak only about one person or one thing, we use positive degree. Just see the example. If I say this man is tall, here means I am talking about one person. So it is a positive degree. Next come comparative degree. Comparative degrees are used when we compare two people or things to each other. So when we compare two person or things with each other, we use comparative degree. So when we use comparative degree, जब हम दो people या दो things को एक दूसरे से compare करते हैं, at that time we use comparative degree. So if I say this man is taller than that one, means I am talking about a man who is taller than the other man. मतलब हमने दो person को compare करा है एक person को other person से. So here it is comparative degree. Next comes superlative degree. Superlative degrees are used when we compare more than two people or things. So when we compare more than two person or thing with one another, we use superlative degree. If I say this man is the tallest in the neighborhood, so what I did, I compared the man with the other man of the society or in the neighborhood, then we are comparing this man with the other all men. So here we are using comparative degree. जब हम किसी person या thing को बाकी other चीज़ों से बाकी other person से compare करते हैं, at that time we use superlative degree. So comparative and the superlative degree are formed in different ways. What are the different ways in which we compare? We add er and est. Here I have given you some of the examples for when we use er and est. Next comes when we use only r and st. Some of the examples are here. Just see, brave, fine, large, nice, noble, pale, simple, wise, white. Here these positive degrees are changed into comparative and superlative degree. So we are just adding R and ST to form comparative and superlative degree. Next form is when we delete the last Y letter and add IER and IEST. So in positive degree, there are some of the examples like costly, dry, easy, happy, heavy, lazy, mercy, wealthy. Here you can notice that the final letter is Y in all the words. In these changes of comparative and superlative, we will delete the letter Y from last and we will add IER in comparative degree and IEST in superlative degree. Did you understand? Okay, now let's come to the other formation of comparative and superlative degree. Here we double the final consonant and add ER and EST. Final consonant means the last consonant. We can see in these words, big, dim, fat, hot, thin. Here the last word is a consonant. In big we have G, in dim we have M, in fat we have T, in hot we have again T, in thin we have N, the final letter. Okay, so when we change it into comparative and superlative, we will double the consonant, means G will become double. It will become bigger, biggest, dimmer, dimmest, fatter, fattest, hotter, hottest, thinner, thinnest. Got that? Now next comes by using more and most. When we add more and most, students always remember, when we have only one syllable in any of the word, then we use the previous formations that I told you. But here we will have something different, that is we will add more and most. Generally we get confused when we use more and when we use most. So when we have more than one syllable in any of the word, then we use more and most. Okay, so there we have some of the words: active, attractive, beautiful, brilliant, careful, courageous, cunning, difficult, famous, faithful, proper, popular, splendid. In all these cases, we will add more and most to form comparative and superlative degree. I guess you understand. Now we have the exception. What is exception? Exception means when our rules does not follow in any case, at that time we call it exception. So here we have an exception, means we have irregular comparison. We have exception in the sense, as I told you earlier, that we have to add ER, EST, we have to add R, ST, or we have to delete Y and use IER and IEST. Okay, these grammar rules which I told you to form comparative and superlative degree, when those rules are not applicable, then we call it exceptional comparison or we call it irregular comparison. So here we have some of the comparisons like bad. It will not become badder or baddest, it will be worse and worst. Evil. Evil will not become eviler or evilest, that will be wrong. We will use worse or worst. Okay, in the same way, there is a word that is good. We will not call it gooder or goodest. Okay, we will call it, the comparison will be better, best. So here you can go through all the irregular comparisons which we have in exceptional cases. Just go through this all and understand. So students, just go through all the comparisons and understand the degree of comparison. Thank you.